champion, brand new tag team champions, and a champion was stripped. SmackDown this past Thursday night had it all. Welcome everyone to Velocity. We're kicking things off with the French phenom, Rene Dupree, on what is going to be a great Saturday night. I'm Josh Matthews, ringside with Bill DeMott. What's up, Billy?
Well, Junior, I don't want to take away from any of the action here on Velocity, but with all of the talk the past few weeks, I can't wait to get to Providence, Rhode Island to see the match everyone's been talking about, the Steel Cage match.
Oh yeah, the WWE Championship will be on the line this upcoming week on SmackDown inside a steel cage. JBL versus Eddie Guerrero, but so much happened with JBL this past week on SmackDown, and we got it all. We got all the highlights right here on Velocity.
And weighing in at 201 pounds, he is the member of the full-blooded Italians, Fuzio.
Sicilian shooter, the Italian Piranha Nuzio, going to go one-on-one with the self-proclaimed French phenom Rene Dupree right here on Velocity. Bill, what do you want to talk about first?
The dog.
It's a French poodle.
It's a dog.
All right, well, what would you like to talk about? Fifi.
Why is there a dog here on Velocity?
It's Rene Dupree's mascot, Fifi, the French poodle. I'm going to get a mascot. What kind of mascot you think I should get, Bill?
You are a mascot.
Here we go, collar and elbow tie-up by Nunzio and Rene Dupree.
Well, here's the second part of my question now.
Dupree showing off his strength there, throwing Nunzio to the mat.
Come on, I want an answer for this one.
Okay.
Why does Rene Dupree have those little marks above his name?
Oh, those are accent marks.
I don't have an accent.
Yeah, but Rene Dupree's French.
Rene Dupree is in the US of A.
Nunzio.
We don't put accent marks on our name.
Nice counter there by Rene Dupree. What the hell are you talking about?
I'm just asking questions. This is what I do.
You got everything happening on SmackDown. You got a champion versus champion match. There was a champion stripped. We have brand new tag team champions, and you want to talk about accent marks.
And we had the Mexican champion.
That's what I'm talking about. The champion of Mexico, El Gran Luchador, going one-on-one with JBL.
Well, he didn't have accent marks above his name.
Nunzio trying to pick the leg of Rene Dupree, takes Dupree down. Dupree doesn't like that very much. And now Nunzio trying to take out the tree-like legs of Rene Dupree. Ducks the clothesline on the other side. Drop kick to the knee, and Dupree is down. Nunzio going about 155 miles per hour here. Now up on the top rope, and Dupree picks the ankle of Nunzio right off the top rope. Nunzio might have broke his tailbone.
That's his coccyx.
I'm sorry, what?
He broke his coccyx bone.
Are you allowed to say that?
That's the name of the bone, coccyx.
Knife hand chop and then an open hand chop by Rene Dupree, exposing the chest of Nunzio.
But Rene Dupree continues to pose after every offensive maneuver, which becomes offensive.
I agree. We already mentioned that JBL took on the champion of Mexico this past Thursday night on SmackDown, El Gran Luchador. Bill, you were telling me earlier that we did see two El Gran Luchadores.
No, one of them was
Eddie Guerrero cover and a kick out by Nunzio.
We saw some ham and egg in a mask,
and then
we saw Eddie Guerrero in a mask.
That wasn't Eddie Guerrero. That was El Gran Luchador, the champion of Mexico.
I saw a shoulder shimmy. I heard Eddie Guerrero's voice, and I heard Eddie Guerrero's music. I know that was Eddie Guerrero.
I'll tell you what, we're going to let the fans decide, because we're going to have those highlights still to come here on Velocity, and everyone is still talking about the huge surprise this past week on SmackDown, the shocking event that went down, Kurt Angle stripping John Cena of the United States Championship. Nunzio, small package, Dupree down, this one could be over. No, a kick out by Dupree.
The shocking event was that John Cena would hit Kurt Angle.
What?
John Cena hit Kurt Angle.
Dupree calling for the end of this matchup. Nunzio trying to counter with the sunset flip. Can't get Dupree over. Dupree snatches up Nunzio and now a bear hug in the middle of the ring. Nunzio has nowhere to go. Can you tell me one more time what you just said?
John Cena has been on probation.
Correct.
John Cena was warned not to touch the general manager, Kurt Angle, and John Cena clearly hit Mr. Angle.
It was an accident.
Accidents happen. Rules are rules. Mr. Angle runs this ship by the rules.
So that's grounds for Kurt Angle to take the United States Championship away from John Cena?
Kurt Angle did not take anything from John Cena. John Cena gave it back because he broke the rules.
Kurt Angle's been trying for weeks and weeks and weeks to get the United States Championship off of John Cena. He's put Cena in championship matches every week. Cena's come out victorious, and now, oh, what a DDT by Nunzio. And now Mr. Angle uses this loophole and strips John Cena of the United States Championship. Both Nunzio and Rene Dupree are down. Bill DeMott, you're wrong.
Well, if you look at your contract, Junior, I'm sure there's a loophole here and there, too.
Whatever, Bill. I'm glad to see that we're running things on SmackDown by loopholes. Covered by Nunzio and a kick out by Rene Dupree. It's wrong. Any way you look at it, it's wrong what Kurt Angle did to John Cena.
Rules are rules.
Well, regardless, what's done is done. John Cena has been stripped of the United States Championship. Nunzio goes between the legs of Rene Dupree. And a missile drop kick from the second rope with those size 15 boots. Cover by Nunzio. This one's going to be over. Two. Sonoma kick out by Rene Dupree. Very competitive match going on right now. Nunzio going back to the top rope. It paid off for him earlier. This time it does it. Rene Dupree dunks the high crossbody.
And what the hell is this?
The French tickler by Rene Dupree. Dupree signaling for the ending. Michinoku driver shoulders down, and Rene Dupree picks up the victory. Trying to get back in the United States Championship title mix. A victory here on Velocity could do just that. What is this?
It's a French tickler.
No, what is the French tickler?
I have no idea. All I know is tonight on Velocity, Hardcore Holly and Billy Gunn go up against the always unpredictable Fashion Brothers. This is going to be a great matchup. No.
Make sure you pick up your copy of To Be The Man. Bill, did you read it?
I am the man.
What?
Following contest is scheduled for 1 fall, approaching the ring from Japan, weighing in at 237 pounds, Sakuta.
Sakuta always looking serious with his Japanese strong style. Sakuta set for singles action.
You know, I'm sure there's a few chapters of Bill DeMott in that book.
Yeah, Bill, I'm sure there are a few chapters about you. Sho Funaki! I'm in Funaki's book.
Funaki doesn't have a book.
Yeah, he does. It's a coloring book in Japanese. I'm all over.
How do you color in Japanese?
Funaki and Sakuta are going to go one-on-one here on Velocity.
Exactly. What kind of match are we going to see here?
Well,
Japanese superstars.
I thought you were asking me a question.
No, I'm just throwing things out at you.
Got two Japanese superstars. Sakuta, as I mentioned, Japanese strong style. Funaki, more of a cruiserweight style, more of a high-flying style.
Both Japanese superstars, yet Sakuta stands in the middle of the ring and says, shake my hand in English.
Funaki is better on the block. Funaki's not going to fall for the oldest trick in the book.
Oh!
Funaki, the best right hand in the business. Showground reversal by Sakuta and a boot to the midsection. Funaki is down.
It was an illegal right hand, by the way. It was a closed fist.
Yeah, you're a real stickler for the rules, Bill.
Rules are rules.
Our rails are rails.
Oh, restart the side of the ball. Oh, that deep arm drag there by Shun Funaki. And another one chains a Ricky the Dragon Steamboat with those arm drags. Shoulders down. Sakona gets stuck. Let me ask you, what are you going to do this upcoming Thursday night?
Well, Thursday night, I'm going to be watching SmackDown. What are you
going
to be doing?
I was thinking about going to the $250,000 live Raw Diva Search casting special at the Beacon Theater in New York City.
How much is that?
It's $250,000, Rain Man. I knew that. Sakona, shoulder down, gets it up. You knew what? You asked me how much it was.
Well, I just wasn't sure.
Well, for those of you who want to go, get tickets. They will be available on 74th Street and Broadway starting Monday morning at 11 a.m. Tickets are complimentary, but space is definitely limited. First come, first serve.
Yeah!
Sakona back suplex on Funaki. Funaki bouncing off the mat like a basketball.
But Sakona taking his time for the cover.
There's the cover, hooks the outside leg, and Funaki kicks out. So you got SmackDown, then the Raw Diva Search casting special. It's going to be a great Thursday night. It probably won't be a great Thursday night for Paul Heyman.
Back up, Paul.
Come on, wait a minute. Why not? Why wouldn't it be a great Thursday night?
Well, because this past week on SmackDown, Paul Heyman made a public apology to The Undertaker. It was a real sincere apology. Paul Heyman ran off a piece of tape, covered, kick out by Funaki.
Paul Heyman, who's never been at a loss for words.
Yeah, who makes apologies on paper?
You beat me to it. How do you apologize and read it off the paper?
Paul Heyman even lost where he was reading from at one point.
Okay, so let me paint a scenario for you.
Okay.
The Undertaker, the dead man, the legend, looking over your shoulder. He's so nervous he has to read it off a piece of paper, and then you say he even read it wrong.
Yeah.
What would you do in that position?
Well, Paul Heyman is scared, and I don't blame him. I would not want to be in Paul Heyman's shoes. The Undertaker is going to get Heyman one way or another. And you think that Heyman thinks he's going to slide? No shot. The dead man is going to take out Paul Heyman, and he's making him wait, which is even worse.
I think
cover. A kick out.
The biggest blow to Paul Heyman right now is there was no answer. No rebuttal. Nothing was heard from The Undertaker this past week. That alone would scare the hell out of you.
Paul Heyman just has to sit and think about the fact that Paul Bearer was buried alive at the Great American Bash and everything The Undertaker has done, and now The Undertaker has promised to get Paul Heyman. Reversal by Funaki, and there Vincent Funaki with the bulldog. Funaki trying to get to the cover. Lateral press, cross the leg, and a kick out by Sakona.
Here comes Funaki.
Hey, watch your fist. Funaki, come on, no problem.
At least the referee's telling about the closed fist now.
Sakona with the reversal. Funaki catches the boot. A boot of his own. But there's the instant worry by Funaki. Cover, hooks the leg, and still doing. Now a kick out by Sakona. Funaki, get fired up. Another right hand. Now a chop. And another one. Sakona fires back.
Funaki going toe-to-toe with the heavyweight Sakona.
Great exchange of chops there, but Sakona rakes Funaki in the eyes. Short arm reversal.
Here we go.
Sakona's got Funaki up. And just drops Funaki. Cover hooks the leg and a kick out by Funaki.
And here's where I see Sakona. This is my favorite part because Sakona doesn't listen to me every week. He looks around for an answer instead of finishing his opponent off.
Funaki hooks the ball. Maybe Sakona gave Funaki too much time, gets the boots up.
Oh!
Super punch by Funaki. Tornado DDT coming. Sakona counters. And another counter by Funaki. Sunset flip. Sakona stacked up. Funaki gets it. Too much time. That's probably what happened. And Funaki able to pick up the victory here on Saturday night.
Up
next Veterans Hardcore, Holly and Billy Gunn look to school the young Basham brothers in a lesson of tag team wrestling.
Will experience have the advantage? We'll find out next. Congratulations to Billy Kidman and Paul London, the new WWE Tag Team Champions.
Total Tag Team Contest is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring from Columbus, Ohio, at a combined weight of 495 pounds, Doug and Danny, the Basham Brothers.
And tonight, WWE Velocity is being brought to you by Activision. Take New York for a spin in Spider-Man 2 The Game.
And my Starburst, pick up a pack of Starburst fruit juice and let the sun shine in. Is it like juicy?
And my Stack of Twos, YJ Stinger.
I'm
for that street boost of energy, you got to feel the sting.
I'm a madman.
Got a combined weight of 503 pounds. Hardcore Holly and Billy Gunn.
Here they are.
I love the show.
These two guys, Billy Gunn and Hardcore Holly, I say it all the time, put the FU in fun.
And I'm gonna kick them. It was out of my life.
Getting the FU in fun.
I saw Funaki put the FU in fun. But his name is Funaki. F-U-N-A-K-I. And Bill, that reminds me of another team that got started right here on Velocity. Billy Kidman and Paul London. They are now the WWE Tag Team Champions. They got their start right here on Saturday nights on Velocity.
Well, you and I touched on it last week when Billy Kidman and Paul London upset the Dudleys via DQ, that if they could win that match, they would be number one contenders. Hard work pays off. And listening to Josh Matthews and Bill DeMott has paid off for Paul London and Billy Kidman, the new WWE Tag Team Champions.
Sure, I mean, you did countless turning points on Paul London. That's only for Paul London to watch, scout, and get better. Now he's a Tag Team Champion.
And this is what we do, Junior. Our job is complete.
I feel good about ourselves now.
You feel about yourself over there, I'll feel about myself over here.
Collar double tie-up by Billy Gunn and Doug Basham.
How many times have we seen this? Let's talk about what else we do on Velocity. We talk about Doug Basham getting in the face of both Billy Gunn and Hardcore Holly every time they're matched up.
Yeah, Doug Basham is not afraid of Hardcore Holly or Billy Gunn. We've seen that before on Velocity. Doug Basham has actually called out Hardcore Holly on Velocity.
I guess now he's going to take his chances with the one Billy Gunn.
Billy Gunn shot to the midsection with that boot. And now a side headlock by Billy Gunn. Basham trying to go for a back suplex. Can't get Billy Gunn over. Now a back roll by Basham, but Gunn hangs onto the side headlock. Both superstars back to their feet. Forearm shivers by Basham. Gunn sets the right. Shoulder tackle by Billy Gunn. Lateral press. Hooks the leg, and Basham gets out before a one count.
There's two superstars that I can think of right now that don't need a fire lit under them. That's Billy Gunn and Hardcore Holly. But now with new champions, it gives them all the more reason to go after the gold.
Leapfrog by Billy Gunn, and what a boot! Doug Basham down, covered by Gunn, and a kick out by Doug Basham. I'm sure the new tag team champions, Billy Kidman and Paul London, are still celebrating, but I'm sure they're scouting this match right here, these four superstars.
Oh!
Basham ducks the hard shot by Hardcore Holly. Danny Basham introduced to this match by Hardcore Holly.
A hard turn just helping him in.
Jump, jump!
You would think that Hardcore Holly could be a good lumberjack. He doesn't need any tools or anything. He can just go into the woods and chop trees down with his arms.
So what you're saying is Hardcore Holly belongs in the woods?
I always take things that I say and misconstrue them.
Paul's one of the baddest men in this business, a lumberjack.
I'm saying that this guy can chop a tree down with his chops.
That's not what you said.
That's right. Why am I arguing with you?
Because you're wrong.
Stop talking to me, please. Depot.
Just another loophole.
Danny Basham tried to run through Hardcore Holly. Hardcore countered with that arm drag. Why you always do this to me? There's the tag to Billy Gunn.
But just like Kurt Angle, I play by the rules. I go by what you said.
Yeah, Kurt Angle comes out, strips John Cena of the United States Championship, and you say that's the rules.
No. John Cena stripped himself of that championship because he was on probation.
Back elbow there by Billy Gunn caught Doug Basham as he was coming into the ring. There's the tag to Hardcore Holly. And now Basham and Gunn. Two-on-one attack. Hip toss in stereo. Basham is down. Billy Gunn wants to see the Alabama crunch.
Oh, this is got to be illegal.
And now there's the two-on-one attack by the Basham brothers. Doug Basham and Hardcore Holly are the legal men. And now the Bashams with the two-on-one attack on Hardcore Holly. Shoulder first to the steel post. What's going to happen? Find out next. We're back on Velocity during the break. The Basham brothers have been taken out. Hardcore Holly cover. A kick out by Hardcore. This is what happened before we went to commercial break.
Well, the Basham's clearly doing what the Basham brothers do best, double teaming Hardcore Holly and throwing him to the outside, and they've been in control ever since.
Yeah, but before Hardcore Holly went to the outside, he went shoulder first off of that steel post, and now the Bashams have pinpointed the shoulder of Hardcore Holly. Hardcore fighting through the pain, trying to break the hold, does, and here we go.
And there's Doug Basham trying to go toe-to-toe again with Hardcore Holly.
Basham now going for a cradle back suplex. Nails it on Hardcore Holly. Basham doesn't go for the cover. Instead, antagonizes Billy Gunn on the outside of the ring.
Cover, and it works. Because now Billy Gunn's in a verbal battle with referee Brian Hebner, and here comes Danny Basham.
No tag was made. Danny Basham now in the ring. Hardcore Holly goes head first over the turnbuckle, and the Bashams are doing what they do best. Two on one, a little chicanery, and they're in the offensive.
And the Bashams are looking to become number one contenders to the newly crowned WWE Tag Team Champion.
Okay, no, we went from calling Billy Kidman and Paul London a makeshift duo. Now, they're the WWE Tag Team Champions. You can call Paul London and Billy Kidman Tag Team Specialists.
Very excited for both Billy Kidman and Paul London. And now very excited to see what happens to the tag team ranks here on SmackDown and Velocity.
Sure, the landscape of the tag team division in the WWE has now changed now that we have new champions in Paul London and Billy Kidman. The United States Championship landscape has also changed, but that's because Kurt Angle decided to strip John Cena of the title.
Oh, come on, for the last time.
Cover, a kick out by Hardcore Holly.
Kurt Angle had permission from the board to enforce his probation. John Cena was on probation. Don't touch me. No touching, no fouling. You touch me, you lose.
It's been said that Hardcore Holly has one of the best drop kicks in the business. You just saw it right there, right on the face of Doug Basham. Hardcore Holly needs to make the tag. Can he do it? Can Doug Basham tag out to Danny Basham?
What I'm watching right now is Billy Gunn screaming, saying, I want in. Let me get this done.
There's the tag. And here comes Billy Gunn. Get fired up on Saturday night. The Bashams are down. Danny Basham, thanks for coming. Gunn ducks the clothesline. Take the world. Cover. This is going to do it. And there's Danny Basham breaking up the pinfall. Here comes Hardcore Holly, and as he usually does on Velocity, things are breaking down.
I love when all four superstars are going head-to-head.
And all four superstars now going full throttle. Gun splash. Here comes the Famouser, Bill. I think this one's going to be over.
This one's all over, Junior.
And Danny Basham hooks the leg.
Oh, turn around.
Hardcore Holly. Remember, Billy Gunn and Doug Basham are the legal men.
And we've seen this at least one other time. The GHB, the Gunn Holly Bomb, and this one could be over.
The Gunn Holly Bomb, covered by Billy Gunn, and it's over.
Control of Basham, hitting the ropes. Here comes Danny to pull Billy out. But what Danny Basham refuses to realize is that Billy's partner, Hardcore, is right behind him. Bam! Hardcore sets him up for the GHB, and you and I both know too much GHB, and no one's getting up.
And now we head to Providence, Rhode Island this upcoming week on SmackDown. The WWE Championship is on the line. It's JBL Guerrero 3 inside of a steel cage on SmackDown.